morning, fam. What is up? My name is Kat Shultis if you're new here to this channel, but this weekend's vlog is going to be a super exciting and fun one. So I've been to Passion since high school. I've been so many years. I love it every year. But this weekend I'm vlogging Passion Conference, Passion 2022. I've never really documented it or anything. So I think it's gonna be so fun for me to be able to like look back at this year and remember like all the speakers and everything because like we kind of vlogged some of it. So basically that's what this weekend is gonna be about. We're gonna take you along. I'm obviously not gonna be vlogging every single moment because I'm gonna be just in the moment and like relational and like praising Jesus. But I still wanted to capture some of it to kind of give you guys an idea of what conference is like, especially if you've never been before, because you need to go. But without further ado, let's jump in. I'm gonna start by kind of telling you what we've already done this morning. It is Sunday before Passion starts tonight because we've been scrambling around like crazy people trying to get ready because we're doing an HWLF event for some of our ambassadors and influencers coming into town. If you don't know, HWLF is like the small business that me and my husband Casey run. It's a Christian e-commerce company answering the question, what would Jesus do? He would love first, HWLF. And so we had a fun event for a bunch of our ambassadors and influencers and people just that like support us coming in for Passion Conference. And we were like, we want to give you guys like a swag bag, some food, get to know you, just kind of like form a relationship with you. So Steph, our social media girl, and then Doug, a friend of ours, and Casey really planned this awesome event, and so many amazing people came and we were so thankful to get to meet them. Anyways, I have some clips of that later and stuff, but basically what we were doing Sunday morning was I went to pick up one of my Be a Blessing girls from the airport and drop her off at her hotel and like help her get situated and stuff, and then I ran to the grocery store, got some last minute stuff that we needed for the HWLF event, like some drinks and snacks. Then I went to Target, got some stuff I needed, like makeup, clothes, you know, you gotta feel like your best self if you're doing a lot of events and stuff like that. So I ran to Target to get the essentials and then came home, got the event ready, and my friend Sid came into town from Charlotte because she is going to conference with us. So I'm so excited to share that with you guys and hopefully kind of show someone who's never been to Passion what it's like, how amazing it is, and encourage you to go to Passion 2023. So without further ado, here's the vlog. That Jesus is God. Event. Yes, my hair is still in the braids. They're still not dry, but we'll get them out at some point. It's fine.
Yeah, they're damp.
We have the influencer bags in the back and drinks and stuff, and we're going to set up some. Steph and Doug are getting food and things, and then it's going to start. It's going to be so fun. So yeah.
Pumped!
We're excited. Okay, you guys, so the HWLF event is over. It was so fun, so good. Met so many fun people. So thankful that they all came. And now we are about to run down to MARTA to take, it's like our subway above ground, to take the train to Passion, so.
It's gonna be good.
Very excited. We have the guys waiting outside for us, so we need to get going, but it's gonna be good. Casey's charging up his phone real quick.
Just charging. Shout out, Lucas.
I wish it was wide angle. I need the other lens. Red Marta.
Whoa.
Queen energy.
Yeah, I mean, you're not wrong. I love how you have to hold it so far from your body.
Oh my gosh, because I don't have my angle. And my arm is short.
Both of those things make it hard.
Very hard.
Thank you.
pouring rain, and Cindy is trying to make a poncho right now.
Why? Because someone didn't get ponchos.
I was supposed to buy them, but I didn't.
I don't know, I'm waiting for it. I might fall into you.
The moment we were all waiting. So, we're walking in the rain. It sits mad because I haven't came around in the rain.
There's so many, I heard so many right things.
She's a sick girl. We're gonna take care of her, give her a lot of supplements. Honestly, it looks like a funny like emo band or something walking in the rain.
Okay, you guys, I'm sorry. This has been literally the most chaotic vlog of all time, but that's what passion is a lot of chaoticness mixed in with a lot of worship and awesomeness. We are back at the house eating some leftover gusto from the HWF party and just chilling. Sid's about to get in the shower. And we're gonna close this vlog out and start back tomorrow we're gonna close this night out and start back with day two tomorrow. We're so excited. It's gonna be so good.
Hey, baby. You ready to get up?
No.
Can you get up from fashion day two? No. Are you sleepy yet?
One of them is navy blue, and that's what I should have worn.
Wear that one.
It is Monday, January 3rd, the last day of Passion, second day of Passion. We're so excited. We slept in this morning because we just were so tired and got back at like 1 a.m. because we live a little bit away from the stadium. So anyways, we slept in a little bit, kind of skipped the first session, and we're about to make our way over there for the second session. We've just been chilling, having breakfast, reading, drinking coffee, talking. It's been a great morning, but we're excited to get back over there. So I wanted to recap last night and kind of like how it went and everything. So we left here off to the HWF event and we marched to Passion. And then we got there, Passion Worship started. We sat with our friends Noah and Maddie Heron, and they brought their baby Lion because they didn't have a sitter, so he came for a little bit. After that, Levi Lesko spoke. It was really good. Tim Tebow did a little short message, also really good. And then KB led worship's like rap session. I have a really funny clip of our friends Hope and Mark. And like Mark was dancing so hard because, you know, like Christian rap, like some people love it and some people are just like, yeah, cool. Like I, if I'm with a hype squad of people, I'll like get down, but like we were just like chilling, so I wasn't like really dancing. But Mark was dancing hard, and Hope, his fiance, was just like standing there like, and it was just really funny because the like dichotomy between the two of them. I'll put like the clip from the dancing here. So after KB, then Sadie spoke, and it was really good. I'll put like a clip here.
Peter recognized who Jesus was. Jesus, in return, told Peter who he was.
But super encouraging word on truth and identity. And she just always crushes it. So good. And then after Sadie, and David Platt came up and spoke about how God wants everyone to have his word and how God wants us to go to the ends of the world and spread his name.
A number like that feels so distant from us, doesn't it? Like 3.2 billion people. How do you even comprehend that? with this picture in the world, I want to bring it down to just one of them.
Anyway, so we talked for a long time and it was really good. He ended up with a really amazing story about a girl that he heard when he was younger who had been trafficked and who had just never heard about God. And anyways, it was super moving and super good and just kind of driving home the fact that we need to be... They're being so chaotic. I've tried to film this like 3 times. They're talking a lot in the background, so I'm sorry, guys. Thumbnail. All of us just like... anyways, and it was so good. I was like crying a little bit. Sid was crying too when he was...
You don't know that.
I heard you, and you were sick a little bit, but you were also crying. Anyways, it was really good, and we're super excited. We left during Crowder because we were like, we need to get to MARTA before it's, like, too packed, which I don't like to leave conferences early, but everyone was really tired, so we left.
Like, 3 minutes early.
3 minutes early. Anyways, so we're about to head back over that way, and I'm super excited for Christine Kane speaking today, and then Louie. I don't know who or when, who... is speaking when, but those are the two I'm like most excited for. So let's get it. So excited. We're not taking MARTA again today though, because they're scared of MARTA.
I'm not scared.
Someone peed on the seat.
Someone literally peed on the seat when we were on last night. So they're a little traumatized. But me, I'm just like, you know,
I'm not traumatized. I went to Georgia State.
Yeah, Casey's used to the Atlanta life. Okay, signing off. We'll see you at conference.
That's what's on the table for you. Father, I want to thank you.
Day after Passion, we slept so late today, but now we're feeling good. I feel just like so spiritually charged after a conference like that, after just being with so many amazing people, even if you're so drained and tired, which I'm not half as drained and tired as I'm sure all the people who actually put together Passion are. I'm sure like Louie and Shelly and just everyone is like, they're probably still not done working, honestly. They're probably still like figuring stuff out and getting people to airports and cleaning up stuff and just... I'm sure the crazies do not end last night, didn't end last night, but I'm so thankful for everyone who made conference happen and all the leadership involved. It is just truly such a special part. I can't talk, that's how tired I am, sorry guys. It's just truly such a special weekend or a couple days to be a part of every single time. This is my 7th Passion Conference, and I don't think I said this at the beginning of the video, but it is my 7th Passion Conference, and I've loved it just as much every single time. Casey asked me today, he was like, was this your favorite Passion Conference? And I was like, well, no, because like the ones like from 2015 to 2018 when I went, I was just walking through some insanely, insanely tough times and a loss of identity from running and injuries and just struggling with a lot of things and depression. And just the enemy seemed like he was winning in a lot of areas, and it always seemed like Passion came at the exact perfect time. Like, I might cry saying this, but like just to drag me out of like whatever pit the enemy had gotten me into again with all of that. And I'm just forever so grateful. Like, I would just be so honored to shake Louie Giglio's hand and say thank you because the Lord used you in so many massive ways in my life, and like will forever continue to. Those are definitely my favorite years, just because looking back on them, I see all that God was doing in my heart, and I still, when I like speak or blog or in my book, I still quote things that Christine Kane said in 2018 or that John Piper said in whatever year and stuff like that. It's like it never leaves me. The God wings he gives us and the moments that we have with him and the wisdom that we're seeking out, it doesn't leave us. And he just uses that throughout the entire course of our life, and I'm so grateful. But before I do like a sit down video kind of like recapping all of conference, even though you're probably like, well, you kind of just did that, I wanted to go into a little bit more detail because I wasn't going to be like not in the moment and like vlog everything we were doing, just everything that was happening and all this stuff while we were there, because I wanted to be in the moment and really just like love on the people around me and just soak in the Holy Spirit. And yeah, I got some fun clips and stuff, and it'll be a fun little thing obviously to watch before this, but I really wanted to sit down and do some deep talks. But first I'm gonna make some green juice, because you guys know, if you watch any of these videos, the green juice is essential. It just is. Especially because today I woke up, like, I'm not sick, but when you don't sleep and you're probably like dehydrated, you just wake up and you're like, gosh, I'm like perpetually thirsty. And I feel like green juice kind of helps solve that. So we're gonna make some delicious green juice. And our apartment is also like literally so freaking messy, because we've been, I'll do more of this in the sit down video, but we've been out of town and just everywhere for the past like 3 weeks, and like not sleeping here, not like doing life here, and just life is a little bit messy right now, and that's okay. And then Sid's air mattress and everywhere that she slept is over there messy. The dishes are overflowing out of the sink, and my closet looks so bad. I'm doing a load of laundry right now, and we'll get to the dishes after I make some juice. But yeah, it's been a chaotic time, but we're gonna get back on track. Everything's gonna get organized. Let's make some green juice and then keep chatting. You guys, green juice has been acquired. We also actually did the dishes and put up the air mattress and cleaned up the living room and played some worship music for a minute. So I was like, I just can't do a sit down video until I'm a little more organized. And now I have the door open to our porch, fresh air is flowing in, green juice. We're feeling good, we're organized now. So basically this video, it's not gonna be like super emotional or deep or anything, even though we are talking about Jesus, so we might get there. But I kind of just wanted to talk about kind of my favorite things from certain messages and stuff. Every message is amazing and so like of the Lord, but I think the Lord definitely uses different people and different messages to speak to different people in different ways in what they're going through, and like a truth that they'll need to hold on for a long time. Because I still have like Christine Kane quotes and like things that I quote from like conferences so long ago that are still just so helpful, and I've used my entire life. So I wanted to kind of dive into some of those moments from this conference for me that maybe you guys who didn't get to go, or you guys who did and just like didn't really fully realize how much this quote would mean to you or something, I just wanted to go over some stuff. Anyways, so I think my favorite message was Jenny Allen's. It just took the cake, which in the past, I love Jenny Allen. I've read some of her books. I look up to her so much. She's amazing. But in the past, it was kind of one of those people where you're like excited when they speak, but it's not like it's your favorite speaker. You know, like, I don't know. Like, to me, it's always like Louie, maybe Sadie. Like, I wasn't expecting Jenny to be my favorite, at least. And she just blew it out of the water. And I just think her message was so, so needed. She touched on a lot of topics that are just not really talked about in the church. And she touched on it in a way of like repentance, like this conviction, this shame that you're battling with, like XYZ things that you are doing or are addicted to or whatever, or did in your past life, like the shame you struggle with from those things. Like, you're free of it in Christ, and you just need to talk about it and like let it go and not live in shame anymore. Because that's the enemy's biggest lie to us, is that we're gonna be stuck in that forever, and then we have to be ashamed of it forever, and we can never just like let it go. But she like talked so much about how there is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. There is no condemnation in our Christ Jesus. And she talked about that. She said it like 100 times in her message. And I think that's like something we know as Christians, but I think her mentioning some very like triggering words or like sins, because it's like we are all sinners, and like we know that, like, or we should know that. And like for me, like sins I struggle with, maybe like insecurity or like thoughts of self-righteousness or like doubting others or like thinking poorly of others, and just like even just thoughts in our minds that we have are sins. And like we are all sinners and we will never be perfect, but I think she touched on some sins that people like for some reason like level sins. Like they're like, if I've done this, I'm worse than this person, or if they've done that, I'm better than that person, you know. And that's not true at all. Like, we are all sinners and we have all fallen short of the grace of God. But Jenny did such a good job of touching on some of the most like untouched on sins, and was just like, this is covered too, you guys. Like, you get to say this out loud and say no to it. Say, I'm not gonna struggle with this anymore. Say, that may have been my past life, that may have happened, but God forgives me, and there is no condemnation, there is no shame left. And her message was just so good. I could talk about it all day. It really touched me, and I know it moved so many in the room, and I think it's going to continue to move many more people for years and years to come. And then I think my favorite worship was either Sean Curran or Maverick. I just think Sean, I've read one book. I've been reading Tozer recently, and he, after Pursuit of God, which is the book I just read, I'm reading Pursuit of Man now, which is kind of about God's pursuit of us and what worship is for and how we're made to worship and just what worship is and what is not and everything. Anyway, so I've been like diving into that a little bit, and Sean started worshiping, just some of the stuff he was saying, praying through, just the way he leads us into the like presence of God just so beautifully. And it's just not about him, and you can tell that, and like you can tell that with all the worship leaders of Passion. They're all amazing, but there's something just special about Sean. And I like looked over Casey, I was like, Sean's worship is Tozer approved, which our worship does not have to be like approved by anyone, like it's approved by God, you know, I know that. But I just was like joking with Casey because he knows how much I talk about Tozer and like how much I love Tozer. And anyway, so it's like a funny moment me and Casey had of like, Sean's worship is approved by Tozer, just since I've been like recently reading that. Anyways, so I love Sean. I also just like, and I know like worship is not about like the production or the lights or anything, like I am the first person to like say that, but all of the like butterflies, for anyone there, I'll insert a picture, or for anyone not there, I'll insert a picture, for all like the butterflies on the screens, butterflies are like the way the Lord, like not the way the Lord speaks to me, but a way the Lord speaks to me, and just something like there's been a beautiful like current in my life with the Lord, and just kind of like a symbol of some things in my life. Sean was worshiping and leading, and it was so beautiful, and he was wearing like a shirt with like flowers on it or something. It was just a very aesthetic vibe to me, and then the butterflies too, with kind of like what he was singing and everything. It was just a special moment for me, so that's why I liked it. And then Maverick, obviously, like every single morning, and get to like honor and glorify and praise him every single morning, and honestly all throughout the day. Like they're always playing. I wish there was, maybe there is, but I don't know, I wish there was like a way, I wish there was like a way you could like Spotify Wrapped of YouTube. Other than that, I'm trying to think of my other favorite message. I loved Louis' message when he got to the part about his dad and the Chick-fil-A logo. If you didn't watch yet, I won't like say exactly what he said and everything, because you should definitely go watch the message. I'll have the link below where you can access all of the sessions and all of the worship sessions and all of the recordings of everyone speaking and stuff, because you need to go rewatch it, or if you haven't watched it yet, you need to go watch it, take notes, pray over it, just soak it in, it's so good. And yeah, I loved also the way Christine Kane closed out the night. Those were my top three messages, which they were all like boom, boom, boom. Like the last ones, like I didn't get to hear Jackie Hill Perry's because it was like online recording, because she was literally about to go into labor. but I didn't get to hear hers because we got to the sessions late yesterday because we were just really tired. And yes, so I missed hers. I need to go back and watch it. I will stop rambling because I can't see how long this video is. It's not telling me on the screen. Probably way too long, and you guys are probably ready to stop watching. So thank you so much to anyone who said hi. I had like 5 to 10, not like a ton, you know, but like some people were like, oh, I watch your vlogs or this, and I was like, wait, what? Like, because I consider this like the smallest channel, and the goal is not like to grow it or anything. Like, I just have fun with it. I like encouraging people, and God has given me some extra time on my hands, and feel like this is something I'm supposed to pursue a little bit, so we're doing the best we can with it. But just meeting anyone who is like, this video helped me, or like, thank you so much for this, like, don't belittle yourself, like, you guys encouraged me, anyone I met at Passion, more than I like probably ever encouraged you, so thank you for saying thank you, even though I'm saying thank you to you, you know. But thank you for watching these videos and just encouraging me so much. If you went to Passion, drop below in the comments something that you loved or something God showed you, or if you didn't get to go, drop in the comments what session you're gonna go watch first. Maybe you should start with one. I think that's it. Yeah. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you liked a little snippet of what our passion weekend was like. I know the clips were sporadic, but we had a lot of fun. God is so good. So thankful for Louis and Shelly and just everyone, all the many hundreds of people who made passion happen. And thank you as well, Jesus. Amen. Bye, guys.